tyrants shake their iron rod, and slavery clank her galling chains.
A Freneau sample. Performance of the poetry and prose of Philip Freneau.
With Prescott and Cornwallis joined, together plot our overthrow. In one infernal league combined.
Within these earthen walls confined, the ruin lurks of humankind. More mischiefs here united dwell, and more diseases haunt this dell than ever plagued the Egyptian flocks, or ever cursed Pandora's box. Within these prison walls repose the seeds of many a bloody nose, the chattering tongue, the horrid oath, the fists for fighting, nothing loath, the passion quick. No words can tame that burst like sulfur into flame. The nose with diamonds glowing red, the bloated eye, the broken head. Forever fastened be this door, confined within a thousand more destructive fiends of hateful shape, even now are plotting an escape.
Oh, there's nothing I like better than spending my lonely evenings at the Davis Lippincott store, drinking my rum. Or wine. Yes, I do love my wine. And having a laugh or two with the Cracker Barrel gang. And I never have to worry about the wife waiting up for me. No, we have an understanding. I just say, Eleanor, don't wait up. And she doesn't. And my three girls are most likely getting ready for bed about now. Now, where is that path through the swamp? I almost fell down there. Phew. I wonder what Eleanor is doing right now. Getting ready for bed, most likely. Indifferent as to my whereabouts. They live their life, and I live mine. Now, where is that shortcut to my farm?
Evening, Captain. Yeah? Recognize you from your sailor's waddle. This is quite a storm, eh?
Is that you, Conley? Storm? Yes, so it is.
I'm just on my way over to the Davis Lippincott store for a draft.
Oh.
Will you join me, Captain?
No. Thank you, John, but, I just came from there and... Well, it must be at least 8 o'clock.
Oh, nearly half past.
Oh, past my bedtime. Some other time.
Oh, just barely escaped from the boy's ribbon, did you?
Yes.
Well, be careful going home. The storm's getting worse.
Worse? Oh, yes. Well, so it is. Good evening to you, John. Yes, so it is. Now, where is that shortcut?
It seems hard to believe that old drunken fool was once the young idealistic writer he says he was. If all that was true, he should have had quite a future. I wonder what went wrong. Poor old Freneau. Evening, boys. David? Very funny, James D. Mr. Foreman, I heard you were ribbing Mr. Freneau.
Good evening, John Conley.
You have me at a disadvantage, sir. You seem to know me, but I do not recall ever meeting you.
My name is Robert Slender. I am a stocking weaver by trade, though I am more fond of traveling and writing for my amusements than my more serious occupation. You've met me many times in my creator, Philip Freneau.
You make little sense to me. Either this is a joke, sir, or you take me for a fool.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.